I'm Nina Zipkin, a staff writer here at entrepreneur.com, and I am here with Mamrie Hart. You might know her from her incredibly popular YouTube channel, You Deserve a Drink, because don't we all? She's also an actor, a writer, a producer, and a New York Times bestselling author. Her latest book is called I've Got This Round, More Tales of Debauchery. Mamrie, welcome. Thanks for being here.
Thanks for having me.
So first things first, where did the idea for the book come from?
Well, I wrote a book a couple years ago called You Deserve a Drink. And once that was done and we talked about doing a second book, I felt like I didn't really have any more stories left to tell.
Right.
So basically the concept of this one was that everything that's happened in it has happened since the first book.
Okay.
So I really like actively seeked out adventure and went and tried to find stories as opposed to them just happening to me.
Right. So you work on so many different kinds of projects. When do you feel most creative?
I feel tired a lot. creative? Like, do you mean like in the morning or at night or when I'm drunk?
Yeah. All of the above, like what's, you know, time, space, like when do you feel like most able to work, I guess?
When I'm most productive, I feel like I really go into kind of like hibernating just work modes.
Mm-hmm.
I really envy people who can say, oh, I work best from 8 a.m. to 11 and that's when I write. But for me, I really just try to get away from it all.
Right.
And so I feel I work better in like short bursts alone. So I try to get out of LA and just hang out with my dog in Palm Springs.
Yeah.
And I get more done in like 5 days than I would in a month.
Yeah. And if you ever feel like blocked or stuck, like what do you do? Is it that getting out there and just doing something different? Or
I think it's just the crippling fear of failure.
Sure. We've all been there.
Yeah, exactly. I feel stuck. I feel like someone said to me once, like you can't just output, you have to input.
Mm-hmm.
Because I feel like so many people, all they're doing, especially on a medium like YouTube where there's so much pressure to have a consistent schedule and to go make, I feel like there's... you can get in a rut where all you're doing is creating, and so you're not inspired because you're not inputting. So I like to, you know, just give myself some leeway to actually watch a show or a movie and, you know, get inspired.
Live your life.
But yeah, you know, be a human.
And kind of going on along those lines with YouTube, what is your best advice for creating content that really resonates with people?
God, any YouTube advice, I'm like, I'm the worst YouTuber. I've never had a consistent upload schedule. To be true to yourself, what was the question?
Just that resonates with people, yeah.
It resonates with people. I just feel like it's your authentic voice.
Yeah.
You know, that's the thing that sets YouTube apart from other platforms. You're not, it's honestly the most personality-driven platform.
Yeah.
So I feel like just it's being your true self and speaking to the camera like it is your friends who already know you and like you, as opposed to trying to put on a display like some sort of TV host or personality.
Yeah, and what do you think are some of the biggest misconceptions about kind of building a channel and building a following on YouTube?
Oh, I guess a misconception would be that it's very easy.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know if people still think that. But I know based on how many people are just like, I'll just be a YouTuber. They think it's easy. Should we hold for sound? I don't know how New York does it. Oh, we're keeping it real? Okay. no, I think
Versimilitude,
it's...
Yeah.
Right. Wow. This is actually New York. Now you know.
Not a green screen.
That people are lazy or whatnot because people don't...
Yeah.
They don't take into account that it's... You do have to conceptualize, especially if you've been doing it a long time so you don't get stale. And you edit. And there is a discipline to... There's a discipline to social media, believe it or not. I mean, two selfies and then one inanimate object. That's my rhythm.
So now you know her formula.
Mm-hmm.
So, and kind of going along those lines and being your true self, I know that for a lot of our readers, sort of, the idea of branding yourself seems kind of like awkward or weird and forced. Like, how do you kind of build a brand that's sort of driven by what you're passionate about, but still sort of keep it about you and not sort of, you know, diffuse and kind of strange?
I don't know. I feel like I got pretty lucky that my brand is drinking and hanging out and being like a wacky friend or aunt. So, I don't know. I will say when it comes to working with brands, not just your own brand, just don't become a walking like parrot ad. Like really try to be more selective with what you're promoting.
Yeah.
So.
So what do you sort of factor in when you're working with like a brand partnership?
I think do you actually like the partnership?
Right.
Can it be something that isn't just a one-off so that you're not just again, like just cycling through brands you can actually build a relationship with. That would be ideally is like a, at least a year long sort of across the board promotion. And then also just making sure that whoever you're working with is going to also let you be yourself, because there's too many times you can sign up to promote something and then they're like, for me at least, like bleep your curse words. Like, don't talk about being drunk. And so it's like, do your research on them and make sure they've done your research.
Do they know the name of your channel?
That's what I'm screaming.
So you also collaborate a lot with Hannah Hart and Grace Helbig.
Hate those.
You only made two films together.
Yeah, right.
No big deal. What are the benefits and challenges to kind of working with such close friends?
A benefit I'd feel like is when you're exhausted, at any point when you're together, you can go, I'm having an off day or I'm exhausted. I need you to step up for me.
Right.
And you can also do the same for them. So I feel like there's a collective amount of energy, and at any point you're going to be lower or higher, and you can kind of get each other back where you're supposed to be.
Yeah.
And also just, it's great to have people supporting you, but it's also really great to have people call you out when they know you're either doing something you don't want to do or not acting completely like yourself. So those are advantages. Disadvantages? I don't know. they truly are, you know, two of my best friends.
Yeah.
So we haven't hit any brick walls. You'll hear about it first when we completely hate
on the
each
social
other.
Media.
Yeah.
And kind of a broader question, but when do you think it's a good time to try something new? Like either creatively or business wise, you know?
I don't think there's a correct answer for that, but yeah. I also don't. I mean, at any point,
yeah.
I definitely say make sure you don't want to be a person who is constantly trying something new so no one can know who you are.
Right.
But no, I would never hit pause on trying something new that I didn't want to. You don't want to get stuck.
Yeah. So where can the people find you? Where can they find the book?
I thought you'd never ask. my YouTube channel is You Deserve a Drink. And also, this beautiful book is now available at any bookstore or Amazon online. You name it, they carry it. It's 300 pages of raucous fun.
Thanks for watching, everyone.
You don't want to know where I was keeping that.